Thelma. Welcome back to my channel of Books and Soul. So today I want to talk to you about a book by Jane Austen. It's called Mansfield Park. Mansfield Park is actually, I think, the third novel written by Jane Austen. It's a book that in many ways is like a Jane Austen novel. And what that means is, you know, there is love, there is romance, there are interesting characters, you know, Jane Austen's writing is great in whatever book of hers you read. And she deals with themes that are important for her, which is, you know, social class, social division, poverty, money, all of that is in her books, and in some way or another, her books deal with social critique. She looks at these things that are so common in this time period, and she's not afraid to criticize them or to poke fun at those things. Even though this book is a Jane Austen book and so deals with many things that Jane Austen usually deals with, it's also a bit different. For example, one of the things that definitely strikes you as you read this book is that the main protagonist, the heroine of this book, is not your typical Jane Austen heroine. She's shy, she's timid, she doesn't want to be the center of attention. She's definitely not the center of attention. She's very insecure, introverted, and you know, she's not like Elizabeth Bennet or she's not Emma for sure, but she's an interesting heroine nonetheless. The other thing that's a little bit different is that she looks at poverty in a very concrete way. We are immersed and we are seeing the family life of a very poor family. We actually live with them. We are able to see what they're going through. We're able to see, you know, the family dynamics. It's like a direct way of looking at poverty that maybe Austen hasn't done always in all of her books. The book, in two sentences, basically, we follow Fanny, who is the protagonist. She's the shy, timid, introverted protagonist of this book. She's born into a big family. There's a lot of kids. And so her mother decides to send her to live with her rich uncle and aunt in Mansfield Park, hence the title. There's definitely stuff she's going through because of the separation from her family. But the only friend she really makes at Mansfield Park is Edmund, her cousin. He's the only one that tries to console her after this huge change in her life. And so naturally they become friends. She lives there and life there is pretty tranquil and pretty calm for her until an unexpected event, when the parsonage at the Mansfield Park estate is occupied by Mrs. and Mr. Grant, and Mrs. Grant's brother and sister come to visit from London. It's one of the most exciting events at Mansfield Park, which is in the countryside. We have two beautiful, rich, handsome, and single people coming from London to stay at the countryside with Mrs. and Mr. Grant. So a sort of acquaintanceship develops between the two families, between the young siblings and the family at Mansfield Park. So this book, like I said, deals with many of the typical Jane Austen themes. The one that's definitely important is that of social class, social status, and money. So right from the beginning, we have this weird situation where Fanny, who comes from a poor family, is raised differently than her two cousins, female cousins, Eliza and Mariah. She doesn't have the same privileges as the cousins. She's dressed in a different way. She is constantly being reminded of her place. It almost brings on abuse, like mental, psychological abuse, especially on the part of one of her aunts, who you'll see her character is another story, Mrs. Norris, who keeps reminding her what her place is. And so she keeps scolding Fanny, she keeps complaining about Fanny, and she constantly shows more love to the other cousins and not to Fanny. So Fanny's being raised in this very strange condition and environment where she constantly feels like she's worse, and she keeps being reminded that she is worse than her cousins. As time passes by and as the girls grow up, marriage becomes one of the main themes and main concerns of Mrs. Norris, but also of the girls. And this is also another very important moment in which Jane Austen kind of shows the ugly reality behind marriage at that time period, which is just, you know, marrying for money. And so she really stresses this point, especially with one of the marriage candidates, who is super rich, has a lot of money, a huge estate, but he is really dull and really just an idiot. And yet he's considered as an appropriate life companion for one of the girls. And one of the ways in which he's able to, let's say, conquer, at least partially, one of the girls is by showing off his estate. So there's a day when they all take a trip to this estate, and it's huge and it's immense and just beautiful. And so in this way, wealth is being shown off, and wealth is shown and portrayed as something that makes somebody a good candidate for marriage. Love is put almost aside. And then, like I said before, we have these two siblings, Mary and Henry. One of the things that Jane Austen also underlines is, you know, they come from London. Having connections, having rich relatives, having people who matter, you know, that in your life can really change the way your life will play out. And this is contrasted very much so with Fanny's family. There's a moment in the book where Fanny has to return to her family home. She participates in daily life there. And it's incredible. She's just very surprised. She notices things at home, you know, the poverty really strikes her, and it definitely drives the point across when we've been spending all this time in Mansfield Park, and then suddenly we're being thrown into this poor household. Another theme I want to talk about is that of acting, pretending, and deceiving. So this is a huge one. It's all over the place. So when the two siblings come from London, quite literally, there is acting in this book, because they decide to perform a play, a very inappropriate, a kind of scandalous play for that time. It's called The Lover's Vows. The father's not in the house, and these young people, some of them teenagers, some of them maybe 20, 21, they all gather together. They have nothing to do. They're kind of bored, and they decide they're going to do this play. I mean, the play's kind of scandalous. So, you know, there are inappropriate parts. There are questionable roles that must be played. And it's interesting because they all decide to do this play, and they're all saying that they're acting. You know, it's not who they really are. But it's interesting because the play actually reveals almost symbolically the truth about what intentions they carry in their hearts a little bit. So it's interesting because the parts they play actually correspond more to who they really are, even though they're trying to masquerade that and they're trying to hide that in real life. There is deceit, definitely deceit in this book. It's very, very much out there. The characters lie on purpose. Some of them lie for good reasons, let's say, you know, to protect someone, to not hurt someone. Others lie for the wrong reasons. There's lies to make somebody fall in love with you, to make somebody else jealous, and then there's lying to yourself, excusing yourself, pretending to yourself that what you're doing is fine, even though you kind of know that it's a little bit fishy. So there's all different types of deceiving going on in this book. And the interesting thing is, you know, these girls and these boys are raised with manners, etiquette, precise ways of acting and behaving. You know, so on the outside, everything seems to be fine, and they seem to be decent, good, well-raised and educated people. But that doesn't always correspond with what's inside. So manners do not equal always morality and being a good person. And Jane Austen is playing a lot with that theme in this book, I think, with you know, with these masks that people wear to pretend, so that to society we seem to be fine, we seem to be good, but on the inside, strange things are happening and they're not always good. And so in all of this, in this whole chaotic, kind of deceitful situation, what really stands out is this idea of simplicity and the value of virtue. So here, Fanny really stands out. I think this is what Jane Austen kind of wanted to show us with her. You know, she's shy, she's timid, but she is virtuous. And on the inside, she has a moral code that she's following, and she knows where the truth is. She has a very simple and truthful way of looking at reality and what's going on. She it's interesting because she's kind of an observer of what's happening. Yes, she participates in it in the sense that she is part of it. She lives at Mansfield Park, but she's kind of like the sober observer of what's going on. And sometimes her judgment, because she's just growing up, she's like 15, 16, and she's able to make these very correct judgments about the situation. She sees things that maybe other people don't notice because they're playing into the whole intrigue. So it's actually Fanny's simple heart and simple way of looking at life that in a way makes her different and makes her special. And it's interesting to see Fanny send out like this, because when given the chance, when certain things happen in the book and Fanny is able to really reveal her personality, she becomes a source of inspiration and even motivation for change for the other characters in the book. So, you know, in all of this chaos and when the house is full, nobody even sees Fanny, or Fanny kind of disappears a little bit. You know, she's there, but maybe she's not at the forefront. But when given the space, when given the right conditions, she really shines and she truly becomes a protagonist. And so she also needs to grow, she needs to change, but there's something about Fanny, something about her heart and the simplicity of her heart and her steadfastness that's definitely, that makes her unique amongst the different heroines in Jane Austen books. So I have to say that I really enjoyed this book. I know it's not like one of the, I don't know, most famous novels by Jane Austen, but it was so good. I really liked it and I highly recommend it. I found it very relatable, even though it's from the 19th century. It makes me wonder, you know, how true to myself am I? Do I also put on a mask sometimes, or do I want to make sure that society, that people see me in a certain way, and so I pretend, or I'm not true to myself? And also the fact if me looking at other people, if I look deeper, or I only look at what I see on the outside, do I pay attention only to the exterior, or do I care to look a little bit deeper and see the person that I have in front of me for who they really are? Yes, so Mansfield Park, highly recommend. I hope you read it. There will definitely be more Jane Austen books on this channel, so just let me know maybe which one you would like me to read first, if there's a book by her that you particularly recommend, and I'll definitely read it. And so that's it. I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please subscribe, and I hope to see you all very soon. Bye!